All right, I'm here with my friends, DA, that's Damon Amendolara, and Seth Galina, giving you everything you need to look for in week three. But we're going to start with Thursday night football. The Miami Dolphins get their first win. DA, your reactions from the Dolphins and Jaguars on Thursday night.
How can you not be impressed by the Dolphins? Because they come into this game with no wins, and it's a team that just doesn't have a lot of talent overall. And yet Brian Flores has that roster that always seems to want to prove that it's better than maybe people take them, you know, for granted. And look, the Jaguars are bad, no doubt about it. But I thought Ryan Fitzpatrick played really well early, seized a moment where he realizes there's actually some eyes on him on a bad Dolphins team. So maybe he's playing to the crowd a little bit when he's wearing that huge Hawaiian t-shirt afterwards that's unbuttoned all the way down to his navel. And I think he's probably prepared for a broadcasting career, but the Dolphins were impressive last night against a bad team. My big takeaway from the Jaguars is what happened to the offensive line and what happened to Gardner Minshew. The offensive line was awful and Minshew was terrible last night. Borderline unwatchable.
One of the things that I was worried about going into this game was the Dolphins man coverage unit against any type of receivers, because they let the Bills receivers, who obviously have a good receiving core, do whatever they wanted to them without Byron Jones on the field. Now, I thought even without DJ Chark, they would still have their troubles, and they didn't. Like, they played pretty well, and that was really surprising. And then the other side of the field, Ryan Fitzpatrick, like DA said, like, we got our one, or maybe, you know, Ryan is great because he'll give us six games a year where he looks like he's like, okay, well, yeah, this guy's been playing the league since, you know, 1975. And he looks like a quarterback that's been around. And then we kind of forget the other, you know, 8 to 10 games in the season where he's throwing balls directly to the other team. But at least this one happened on national TV. So shout out to Ryan Fitzpatrick, who had a great game.
What a motivation for all of us, from the shirt and the chest hair hanging out to, you know, velocity of a high schooler, and he still gets the job done. I love it. You know, that is my biggest takeaway, is Ryan Fitzpatrick has games where he can play unbelievable, but you also get Mike Gesicki, the emerging tight end who's crazy athletic, wasn't great as a rookie. He's looking great this year. I was disappointed in Gardner Minshew, the same as you, DA. We're coming out of 2 weeks where he looked awesome, and Gardner Minshew looks like he's tank-proof. Like, you can't get Trevor Lawrence with Gardner Minshew playing like this. But there's still enough question marks. He doesn't have the greatest arm in the world. And then the biggest thing for him is his decision-making. Had a couple poor decisions last night. His pocket presence still needs some work. So you've got Minshew magic, and you also get the lows, very much like a young Ryan Fitz. So, I mean, it really was, you know, like Spider-Man emoji last night, except at different ends of the age spectrum. So let's go to this weekend. Dallas Cowboys and the Seattle Seahawks, one of the biggest games of the week in the NFC. DA, what are you looking for in this one?
Russell Wilson's brilliance. Through the first 2 weeks, he has just been nearly flawless. And I mean, that stat from Sunday is amazing. That last year, the Patriots secondary gave up 4 passing touchdowns to wide receivers. They gave up 4 on Sunday night to Russell Wilson and the Seahawks. It just goes to show you how amazing Russell is right now, how much he trusts his deep ball, how much his wide receivers love his deep ball. DK Metcalf has obviously developed into a very, very good target, but Wilson's just playing the position maybe better than anybody else yet so far this season. That includes Mahomes, that includes Rodgers. So I'm looking forward to that. I also don't know if the Cowboys are good. They got beaten by a Rams team in week 1 and didn't look good doing it, and they should have lost to the Falcons last week, except Atlanta gagged it away, which is what Dan Quinn coach teams do. If there's not an onside kick where the Falcons don't know what to do, the Cowboys are 0-2 going into this game and could easily be 0-3 if you lost to the Seattle Seahawks. So I'm still waiting to see if the Cowboys are any good.
Yeah, and even if they lose to the Seahawks and they're 1-2, that might spell doom for the rest of the season. I agree, but I also think the Cowboys are actually good. I know we say this. I was talking to my friends recently, like before the season started. I was like, hey, watch out for the Cowboys. And they were like, but you say that every year. And I was like, oh, man, I did it again. But yeah, I think they're good. And I also think the Rams are actually going to be one of the top teams in the NFC this year. So like, that loss is not the worst thing in the world. But like you said, I mean, going down 20-0 to the Falcons and then kind of winning on one of the flukiest onside kicks that I've ever seen doesn't bode well for the
hypnotizer.
The hypnotizer. So I don't know. I love Dak. I think he's just developed into such a wonderful quarterback that I trust them because he's the quarterback. And I thought Zeke has been running super well this year. But if you're getting a rust game like we've seen the first 2 weeks of the season, I don't know how you can stop him. Someone asked me recently, like, well, what do you do to stop Russell? And I was like, well, if he's making the plays out of structure at the level that he's making right now, I'm not even like, what can you do, right? Because he'll just, if he doesn't like what he sees right away, then he's going out of structure and then he's killing you. And his deep balls have been great again, as always. So right now, Russ seems unbeatable. I'm not really sure what's going on with him, and he just looks incredible.
Yeah, and here's what I'm looking for here. The Cowboys' secondary is depleted. Seattle can't cover anybody. This is going to be like a Big 12 game. It's going to be 50-45 in this one. I think the Cowboys, the story there is their offense started to look like we thought it would, with CeeDee Lamb being that number three, maybe the number two now. Michael Gallup, Amari Cooper, Dalton Schultz actually emerging with Dak throwing the ball well. That's tough to stop. And then with Seattle, yes, Wilson's playing great, but the difference this year is Brian Schottenheimer, who took so much heat for just going run, run, pass, is scheming up screens for touchdowns, wide open drag routes for touchdowns, easy passes in the flat. Russell Wilson's playing great, and he's getting elevated by his offensive coordinator. That's what makes Seattle scary. I'm expecting a Big 12 game that might come down to Mike McCarthy's fourth down decision making. The stuff.
Terrifying.
Going for two down nine. He's making all the right moves. It's going to come down to his aggressiveness versus Pete Carroll's conservative nature. We'll see what happens there. One other awesome game in the NFC, though. Green Bay Packers and the New Orleans Saints. It may have looked a little bit better just a week ago because the Saints are coming off a loss to the Las Vegas Raiders. Everybody's ready to write off Drew Brees. Aaron Rodgers looks like 2014 MVP Rodgers. What's going to happen in this one?
Well, I think that we're going to see more Aaron Rodgers fireworks. I think he's playing at such a remarkable level that even against the Saints, it's not going to slow down. And remember, this is indoors, faster, Superdome. I could definitely see the Packers putting up another 38-41 points like we've seen the first 2 weeks. I think the Saints are a little bit more interesting in this fact. Drew Brees, I think, is going to continue to look 41 years old this year. I think we'll see pockets where he's very good. I think we'll have some games where he's very efficient. I don't think we're going to see swaths of the season, four games, five game stretches, where Drew Brees looks like he's turning back the clock. I think what we see is what we're getting from Brees. But that doesn't mean the Saints are going to lose games. The Saints have a very good defense. The Saints have a great running back in Alvin Kamara. And the Saints last year, when Drew Brees did go down, won those games with Teddy Bridgewater. So I think we could see a Saints team that, even though Drew Brees turns into more of a game manager, not quite as bad as Peyton Manning in 2015, but not quite what Drew Brees we are used to. The Saints could win, but Brees still looks old. But is that enough on Sunday night against a high-flying Packers offense that right now is shredding the team that faces?
The crazy thing about Brees is that, okay, yes, every year he gets a little older. Every year the arm strength wanes a little bit. But when you look at 2017 through 2019 Brees, which is like kind of the resurgent Saints team, you know, that went to the playoffs those 3 years, you really saw an elite quarterback. I mean, this guy was a top five, top three quarterback for those three seasons. And even though there was no arm strength, even though the arm strength had started to wane, now the issue is that the arm strength looks terrible. I mean, they can't even throw the ball past 5 yards. And the accuracy, like, I don't see anything mechanically that's that different. And I wouldn't really want to, like, say anything about Drew Brees, like, kind of perfect mechanics. So I don't see anything that weird about it. But the other thing is, he just doesn't want to throw it to open receivers anymore, which seems weird. You know, his bread and butter was that 10 to 19 yard range. So even though they weren't pushing the ball down the field 20 plus yards, the thing is, Brees never missed an open target. When someone was open in the intermediate game, he found him and he hit him in stride. And now it's A, he's not even throwing them when they're open, and B, he's not hitting them. When he does, he's not hitting them in stride, even underneath. So that is scary. And now you bring in Aaron Rodgers. You know, the Saints defense has been not great the first 2 weeks of the season, but that's kind of a feature of the
Every
Dennis.
Year.
Yeah, that's a feature of the Dennis Allen Saints defense. But the problem is, even if they're better in week three, well, they're going to go against Aaron Rodgers, who's playing the best football, like you said, probably since 2014 in his career. He's on time. He's accurate. You know, he's throwing the ball with such purpose, I find. He looks incredible. So this is a scary thought for the Saints, going down to 1-2 when they really thought that they would be at least 2-0 going into this game. I don't know what's going to happen to the Saints going forward.
Yeah, Rodgers is playing a completely different game, too. He's getting rid of the ball faster than ever, 2.5 seconds. He's usually the guy holding it 3 seconds, trying to extend plays. And again, that's early Rodgers. He could beat you within structure and outside of structure. That's scary if he keeps it up. I'm not completely ready to write off Breeze, but I see those concerns. I think when you get older, it's not just straight velocity. There's reaction time in there. There's just your footwork's not tied up. Your brain's I'm old now too. I'm not the same athlete I was 10 years ago. Your brain's telling you to do something. Your body's just a touch slower. That's what I'm seeing with Breeze, where he's used to be so quick, going through progressions, 1 to 2 to 3, and it's all connected. There's just a slight disconnect there. I don't know how you fix that, but I think that's what I'm looking out for every single week. Which Drew Brees are we going to get? And can Aaron Rodgers keep up that MVP pace?
You want to get rid of me and get back to more great PFF YouTube content? All you have to do is push that button right there and subscribe. Thanks for watching.